These are the mass moments of a rigid body summarized. So these are all quantities that describe the mass distribution. And we could phrase it in terms of questions, answers, and then what the mathematical object is that gives that answer. So the question, if our question is just how much mass is there? The answer of how much mass would be the mass. And I think we've used like capital M, the mass. And this is a, if you want, it's the triple integral, the density. And I'll just assume density could possibly be a function of position. So it's a triple integral of the density integrated over the volume, which is just how much mass there is. And as a mathematical object, this is just a scalar. The next question would be like, if I have the potato, you know, somewhere in this room, you want to know, where is it? Where is it is given by the center of mass. If you want to give like, what's the average location for a mass distribution? It's the center of mass. Where is it? The center of mass, which we've written this way in the book. So the center of mass is 1 over m, and then you would integrate over the body, the density, and then the position of mass elements inside it. That gives you the center of mass with respect to some inertial origin. As a mathematical object, what is this? This is a vector. Scalar has one number, a vector has three numbers. Okay, the next one is, and what we've kind of focused on today, how spread out is it? Might be the natural question. How spread out is it? And that's answered by the moment of inertia matrix, which is that thing. I'm not going to write the whole thing. Actually, it could be written this way. It's the density that R tilde transpose. We just wrote it in a summary form up above, but since I'm short on space, I'll write in that kind of compact way. As a mathematical object, what is this? This is a matrix. Scalar has one number, a vector has three numbers, matrix, it's a 3x3 matrix. It has nine numbers. These are sometimes also referred to as the moments, not to be confused with the moment that means like a torque. It's like you could have a moment for any statistical distribution. This is analogous to a description of any statistical distribution. Like if we're talking about the number of people who have a given height, so let me draw a distribution. How much would be the total number of people? If you want to know, well, where is it? That would be kind of like the mean or the average. If you want to know how spread out is it, that's measured by standard deviation. And in statistics, these are referred to as like the zeroth moment, first moment, and second moment. So the mass up here would be zeroth moment. Center of mass is the first moment. Moment of inertia is the second. And it matches up with the number of numbers in this mathematical object. So a scalar is 3 raised to the 0. A vector is 3 raised to the 1. And a matrix is 3 raised to the 2. And we'll just end with that. Yeah, so you could, I guess, relax now. It's all done, I guess.